laws are very, very simple. I want to make sure I have all your attentions and understand them. There are no practices. The first end that you shoot will be for score. The score is regular scoring for the first arrow. When we blow the whistle, you'll have 1 minute to shoot. There's no allowance for cooling failure. And when you proceed to the targets, make sure you stop at the yellow line. The officials will score the target. And if you are not tied with the highest score, your arrow on target will be pulled and you're eliminated from the competition. All right, here we go. This is for the lucky dog position. Regular story, first down, 1 minute. Good luck.
Is it working?
Marching to the line.
Audio.
All right, so here we are at the Lucky Dog shoot. We've got 44 archers. These are all archers who shot 899. So what we're looking for is one archer from this group who's going to earn a ticket to the finals tonight. They only pick one. We just heard we have 22 who shot perfect 900s, and here we have 44 who shot 899s. They're looking for that one spot. First arrow is for score. The inner 10 ring counts as 10. And then after that, we're going to go to inside out scoring. Same rules as the 10K a day challenge. So the first arrow is away. We'll go down and score and see how many we cut down to. We should mention here, of course, while we're waiting to score down there, we had Paige Pierce, who became the sixth woman in history, I believe, to shoot a perfect 900 in championship compound women's division. And then, of course, Brady Ellison, first 900 in history. First 900 in history here at the Vegas shoot for men's recurve. So those were two significant events from the 930 line. Judges are looking at all the arrows.
Judges, make sure you understand that the X is the 10.
Bruce explaining X is the 10 ring.
The X is the 10, scored regular scoring.
X is the 10 ring, so.
Next thing we go inside out.
Anybody who is in the 10 ring but not touching the X, they will be eliminated. We did see a couple so far. Got some big names in this group here. We've got Braden Gellantine, Tate Morgan, Jimmy Lutz, Chris Schaff, David Hauser, Curtis Broadnax. Walking down the line here, Rich Jackson, he went pretty far last year. He shot a 900, pretty far in the shoot-off. We got Stefan Hansen, Louis Holmes, Paul Tedford, Peter Elzinga.
Judges are complete.
Lots of big names here. Shooting for that one spot, only going to have one. Looks like we knocked out a few in that. Now we're going to go to inside out scoring. So what that means is we have the X ring. The arrow has to be completely inside of it. Cannot touch any line. Bruce Call, president of the Vegas shoot, directing traffic here.
Okay, this is your second official scoring end, and your first end scoring the X as the 10, inside out. If it touches the X ring, it will be out. Once again, 1 minute, good luck.
Heard Bruce call that there. The rules for how this must be scored. And as you look down, when we go down range to look at the targets, you'll see some archers are shooting the three spot. That's what they've been shooting all weekend. Others chose to switch to a single spot for this competition. They want to be able to focus just on one spot down. So I'm looking, I see a couple of really good looking shots down there. A couple archers have to shoot yet. Tate Morgan just came to full draw. Nerves feeling?
Feeling good. House money now.
All right, Tim Hanley, the CEO, he's out here still alive, doing what he needs to do. Now we're getting a look at Tim's arrow there. Perfect shot. Tim sticking with his large diameter arrows, his Black Eagle PS27s, doing what he needs to do. Moving down here, the judges are pulling arrows. We lost a lot of archers in this round. Steve Anderson, tell me about the nerves these guys are feeling.
Yeah, no one really is that nervous. This is whatever, you know. It's like a lottery.
The big cat, Steve Anderson, he's never nervous. All right, we're going to see how many we have left. We definitely dropped a lot on that round.
Okay, most of them are still in. Would you meet me right here? Once again, those of you that are still shooting, please meet me right out here.
Bruce is calling the field of archers still remaining. I see Stefan Hansen, Peter Elzinga, Tim Hanley, Glenn Boardwell.
Okay, the six are ready. First off, my big hand.
Six. Six remaining. Bruce is pushing everyone to the middle for this round. He's packing into the middle now for this next arrow.
All right, this is M number 3. You'll shoot the same thing. 1 arrow, 1 minute. Score inside out. We got 6 guys left. Good luck.
6 archers left. 1 arrow. Any one of these guys is capable of this. We saw last night Sarah Priels won this competition for 10K day. First one down, that's a real good looking shot. Tim Hanley's got a nice looking arrow. See 2 arrows that look real good. Shot at the end there. His looks real good. Maybe a touch low. Let's see what we got. I think Tim Hanley might be just a bit low. Just out. I'm not sure if we have a winner. This might be, we might have to do a reshoot.
So the high score is 9, and we have5 still tied. Give those 5 again around the call.
Okay, we're going to shoot again. So what happened there was we had no inside outs, so the high score was a 9. 5 archers shot a 9. So we only managed to eliminate 1. Looks like it was Peter Elzinga. Just the 1 archer. The other 5, we will shoot again.
Once again, just so everybody watching understands, you must tie the highest score to stay in the shootout.
Do it again with 5 archers this time.
All right, this is scoring 10 number 4. Same thing, 1 minute. X is the highest score. Scoring inside out. Good luck.
Draw. Nikki's. Tim Hanley got a real good shot there. Stefan Hansen is going to be the last archer to shoot. There's 2, 3. Really good looking arrows. Hansen holding dead still. Pretty good shot, but I think that's a little bit low. Tim Hanley's just kicked left. Glenn Boardwell looks to have the closest. Judge is taking a real close look. Tim Hanley's was just a little bit away. So the judge is looking. We may have another reshoot. Not sure if we had any inside outs. Glenn Boardwell was really close. I'm guessing they called it touching the line. So Noah Woodnicki, they pulled his target down. He missed the X. Anyone else? Stefan Hansen. Oh, he's switching his target over. So
if you all change targets, once again, the high score that time was 9.5.
We're going to have five. Excuse me, four left. Four left. Noah Woodnicki missed.
We have a problem. We're going to stay here.
So we have four archers left.
We have an error explained. Peter Gossman was eliminated by accident. He gets to shoot one arrow at the shot. He's agreed to shoot it by himself.
So, Peter Elzinga. Peter Elzinga was eliminated by error, according to Bruce Cole. So he's going to get to shoot one arrow by himself.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, everybody, what happened there, when you score inside out, the confusion that came was all of them shot a nine, but the ones that were called out were still in the nine. They weren't touching the eight. A little bit confusing, you don't normally have that happen, but we're dealing with it, and we're getting ready, so.
So once again, yes, Peter Elzinga.
Peter, you shoot one, shoot one.
He's going to be shooting. And Noah Woodnicki's putting his target back up. So I'm guessing he's still alive.
Okay, we're ready to pop. Same thing here, 1 hour, 1 minute. Score inside out. Good luck.
Again, Peter Elzinga was incorrectly eliminated. So he's getting to shoot his arrow. So Peter Elzinga could have won it outright there if he had shot inside out, because no one has done that yet. But he should be still alive. This should have been enough to keep him going.
Peter shot at 9, and he will be in shoot-off contender.
All right, here we go again.
Okay.
Six archers we've got.
We're ready for the same format now.
Six archers still alive here.
1 minute. Once again, inside out, X bounces down. Good luck.
Okay. Coming to full draw. We're still looking for that inside out to win it outright. If they just keep tying, we just keep going. Peter Elzinga with a very good looking shot. We're gonna go down. Stefan Hansen has an incredible arrow looking from here, from the side. We're gonna walk down. Tim Hanley is wide of the X.
Okay, we'll go again.
Go again. Keep going. Guess Stefan's was touching a line. We're gonna keep shooting. Stefan looking at his arrow. Stefan calling for a judge call. So Hansen wants another look. He thinks he's in. Judge coming out. Stefan's got his light on. He wants a recall. Judges are looking. Judges taking a real good look. They got lights, magnifying glass. This is a big deal, because if he can make it into the 900, he has a chance for that top prize, $54,000. He felt his arrow wasn't called correctly. He wants him to look at it again. It is close. Just looked at a picture of it, close-up photo. Man, it's a tough call. Judges are really taking a look at it. Magnifying glasses. Again. This is.
We got all three judges called, and it stands as out of nine.
All right. The call stands. So they say it is out, so we are shooting again. All six.
We need the line cleared, the officials have made their decision. It's over.
All right, we're going to go again.
Okay.
Six archers.
Inside out. X bounces down. Good luck.
All six archers. Shoot here. We're looking for inside out. The arrow completely inside the X-ray, not touching any line. It's a high shot from Woodnicki high, Tim Hanley low. Stefan's in there. Stefan Hansen looking very confident. This might be it. Hansen's arrow may be just catching that top. Might have knocked out Glenn Borgo.
All right, do it again.
Do it again. Everybody made it.
What's all the time this time?
We're gonna shoot another one. Just keep shooting until there's a winner. Logan Wild here. What as it goes longer like this, as they keep shooting and just missing that line, is that good thing, bad thing? What's happening to these archers?
Well, yeah, I mean, you take Stefan, for instance, who's had two close ones the last two ends. I mean, you know you can do it, obviously, but this last end kind of showed that as it's getting a little longer, they've got a little bit looser on some of the other archers. So at some point, you've got to have the confidence to know that you can put it in. Otherwise, it's just going to get a little bit worse and worse as the day progresses.
All right, thanks, Logan. We're about to shoot here.
Good luck.
Shooting down range here. I think Stefan got that one. Glenn Bordwell is very close. I think we are at least paring it down, if not having a winner. We're gonna take a look. Looks like Hansen finally got squared away in that middle. Stefan Hansen is definitely inside out. Glenn Bordwell's giving the thumbs up. He's liking his arrow. So we may be down to two. The judge is looking that over. Really scoping out Noah Woodnicki's arrow, as well as Glenn Bordwell's. Hansen for sure is inside out. Noah Woodnicki, Glenn Bordwell, Stefan Hansen. Down to those three. Three of them will shoot another arrow. So Tim Hanley, the CEO, got knocked out on that one. I'm sure a lot of people are wondering. Great shooting. This is his first year as a pro, so Tim Hanley certainly did well here this weekend. But we're full draw now. Woodnicki is left. Excuse me, right. Glenn Bordwell's looks good. Stefan's the unofficial call from the line is that Glenn Bordwell is in. Hansen, if he hit the same hole, he's inside out. Hansen's is just a little bit to the right. So Glenn Bordwell. Let's see how he did. Judges are working. Glenn Bordwell.
You've been around all of them, but your winner of the Lucky Dog is Glenn Bordwell.
Glenn Bordwell survives. Great shooting for Glenn Bordwell out of New York. So what that means is he has earned his ticket to the finals, which means he is eligible for that $54,000 top prize in the Championship Compound Open. His sister Katie is standing right here. Katie, how you feeling right now?
I'm so happy for him. I'm sorry, I can't talk.
That's awesome. Katie's waiting here to give him a big hug. Darren Christianberry is getting the team in there. Jacob Marlowe. There he is. All right, Glenn. Let's get a quick word from Glenn here. Glenn, how you feeling right now?
Feel great. Can't wait for tonight.
So those last couple hours, were you getting tired? Were you getting stronger? How'd you feel?
More frustrated. More frustrated. Come on, just put one in there and end this. It felt good to finally get it.
You were so close on a couple of those. The arrows just kicked a little bit up, a little down, just touching the lines there, but you finally got it squared away.
Got it. Can't wait for tonight.
All right, you're still in it. $54,000 on the line. Congratulations,
Thank
Glenn.
You. Thank you.